I'm Robert Bell.
I'm Dawson.
I'm Andrew.
And this is the Adrenaline Factory.
Welcome back. We just cut this piece off the, redo that. So we just ended up cutting this piece of angle that we made for this old window bar here. We originally had it like this, and we measured the windshield out from the Maxima to be cut off on the sides to be the same size as the Lamborghini windshield, because I didn't want to spend $2,700 on a windshield on a drift car and then break it and possibly have to replace it. So we actually got a customer car in here, and it uses a full size Maxima windshield. So we're just going to widen these out a little bit to basically take up that additional gap, which is about an inch and a half on each side. So this was the old one, and we've got the new ones bent here to actually fill that in. And then we'll brace the bottoms of them so we can get a windshield in this thing. Welcome back. For all of you guys that haven't been following very long, we're gonna show you some pictures of what this thing looked like when we first got started. I'm gonna give you guys a rundown of the before and afters.
This is the basic layout for the chassis. This was pretty much all essential bars to hold the car square while we were mounting the body. The body at this point was just a completely unmodified replica Murcielago fiberglass one-piece body. And then we have just a mock-up engine setting in it for, you know, testing clearances and getting motor mounts and stuff ready to be made. At this point, this is just before ICC. We started hanging the body panels and widening them for the correct width offset wheels and all that stuff. We've got the Jeep aluminum radiator in it. We've got the Mishimoto front mount heat exchangers with the power steering coolers, and all the plumbing ran for the radiator hoses and all that stuff. It's a little bit hard to see in the picture, but in the right side of this compartment, there's a reservoir that we made that holds the cooling liquid for the top mount intercooler, and it pumps through that system to the front mount heat exchangers and then back to that reservoir. So this is actually the current state of the car. I believe this picture was taken today. We were working on the window frame to mount the windshield and trying to get the rest of the body panels on the car. So this was pretty early in the build. We hadn't even had the engine sitting in the car at this point, but this is just the basic cage layout for the car. It's inch and a half 095 DOM roll cage tubing. And we had, I believe, just the front suspension hung on it. We had the YSFAB set up from the start. But none of the forward A-pillar bars, window bar, roof bar, floor bars, seat mounts, none of that was done at this point. And this is a pretty current state of the car, pretty much just running, driving, everything mounted. We still have to make the wing mounts, the lift hinges for the rear part, the targa top, and hang windows and all that stuff to get ready for this thing to be body worked and sanded. All right, so at this point of the build, it was pretty early on. We didn't have any of the floor bars in here yet. Didn't have firewall, steering column, steering rack, any of that stuff. At this point, we were basically just building the chassis inside of the body to give us as much room inside the car as we were going to end up with. So this is pretty current. Got the seats in here, got all the floor plates in, all the floor diagonals, fuel tank, center console, all that stuff is pretty much roughed in at this point. We still got to tidy up the wiring, still have a couple more plates to weld in on the upper dash area so it kind of dries the car out. Once we put a windshield in it, it'll seal all that off from air. Yeah, actually, a big part of this that you can't even see is the fuel tank is actually inside the center console. It was about the safest place we could put it while also moving a lot of the weight forward in the car. We made it out of 065 stainless steel, so we don't have to line it if I decide to run E85 like you'd have to do if you did an aluminum cell or something. And also, since it's so long, we had to put diagonal baffling and stuff in it so it doesn't slosh heavy on acceleration or decel. This one here was actually pretty early too, but this is right after we got the engine and trans set in it. At this point, we were trying to figure out how far forward we could move the engine without hurting the axle inclination to make sure that we weren't going to bind axles up and stuff while moving as much weight forward as possible. So right here, we got the tillet seats mounted, centered everything. We've got the entire rear engine firewall plated in on the inside. We've actually, if you were to see a normal Lamborghini, these tubes are actually about the same width. So we removed about an inch and a half of the door jamb to put the tubes in there. So it gives a lot more room to the inside. The shifter is out of Nissan Maxima. And then the steering wheel, steering column setup is out of a RX-8. So a pretty cool thing that we're going to do with the firewall is we're going to put a border around the outside of the tubes on the back. That way we can rivet aluminum panels to the inside of it after we insulate between the two layers. So it'll keep a lot of that engine heat from getting into the car. And if it were to catch fire, then that part would last a lot longer under heat. So at this point, this was actually the very first picture we took of separating the panels. So when we got this body, it was just a one-piece deal. There weren't separate panels for quarter panels or fenders or anything like that. So at this point, we started the separation after we, you know, tabbed out the locations of where the panels were going to mount up. And then we started getting in deep to all the spots that we couldn't reach with the welder with the body on there. Pretty current state of the car. This was just before we took it out and drove it for a couple minutes, giving a buddy of ours a ride. But basically, this is the full width that it's going to end up being. Pretty much a rough shape of the Infernus before we actually fit the headlights and get everything else mounted. So the wiring in the car is still a pretty big mess. If there's anything I've learned over the years, it's to do the wiring part last on the cleanup. Definitely make sure that all the systems work properly before you go through and shorten and loom anything. So we're waiting till we get the headlights and taillights all fully on and functional before we go through and, you know, remove all the extra wires and loom all that stuff up, make it look pretty.
All right, guys, well, thanks for watching, and check us out next week.